So, okay, can you tell me what are capillaries? Let's see, what are capillaries? They are a network of microscopic vessels. When in a cadaver, we tend to dissect the cadaver, we can actually see or view the large arteries as well as veins. But capillaries are microscopic vessels and they connect the venous system with the arterial system. Generally, they have got a very small diameter, like 7 to 9 micron meters, and they exist in almost every part of the body because every tissue needs nutrients and every tissue needs to get rid of the waste products. Okay, so their function is to exchange the good as well as bad products like nutrients and waste products. And microscopically, they are very delicate endothelial tubes and they rest on the collagenous and elastic fibers. So there are certain types of capillaries, and the types of capillaries are different because they are located at different places. At different places, their function slightly varies. So because of the slight variation in the function, there is a adaptation in the structural composition of the capillaries. So there are continuous capillaries. You can see that the cells are opposed to one another. They are joined to one another with the help of tight junctions. And there are fenestrated capillaries. ठीक है, फेनेस्ट्रेटेड कैपिलरीज, यू कैन सी दैट देयर आर स्मॉल फेनेस्ट्रा. फेनेस्ट्रा आर विंडोज. ठीक है, द वर्ड फेनेस्ट्रेशन रेफर्स टू द प्रेजेंस ऑफ विंडोज. सो देयर आर स्मॉल ओपनिंग्स इन दीज कैपिलरीज. लाइक यू कैन सी दैट दे आर प्रेजेंट इन द इंटेस्टाइन्स, दे आर प्रेजेंट इन द एंडोक्राइन ग्लैंड्स, एंड दे आर ऑल्सो प्रेजेंट इन द ग्लोमेरुलाई ऑफ द किडनीज. सो देयर आर other capillaries like sinusoidal capillaries, which are large dilated capillaries, and they are also known as discontinuous capillaries, and they are present in the liver, bone marrow, and spleen. So let us discuss about the continuous capillaries. Continuous capillaries are referred to as continuous because there are no pores present in between the cells. They are very specialized and they are present in those areas where only a specific kind of exchange is required. All the materials should not be exchanged in these kind of tissues. Like, मैं आपको इस एग्जाम्पल से समझाती हूँ दैट इन द लंग्स ओनली द एक्सचेंज ऑफ कार्बन डाइऑक्साइड एंड ऑक्सीजन, और यू कैन सी ओनली द गैसियस एक्सचेंज शुड बी देयर एंड द गैसेस कैन बी डिफ्यूज फ्रॉम द सेल्स एज वेल. अगर इसके अंदर इन दीज कैपिलरीज इफ द पोर्स वुड हैव बीन प्रेजेंट, पोर्स प्रेजेंट होते, ओपनिंग्स प्रेजेंट होती, तो लंग के अंदर वो सब्सटेंसेस भी चले जाते जो रिक्वायर्ड नहीं है, तो लंग में कंजेशन होना शुरू हो जाती. तो एल्वियोलाई के ऊपर जो कैपिलरी नेटवर्क होता है, इट इज द कॉन्टिन्यूअस कैपिलरीज बिकॉज जस्ट गैशियस एक्सचेंज कैन टेक प्लेस. ऑल राइट, एज वेल एज यू कैन सी दैट दे आर प्रेजेंट इन द ब्रेन. ब्रेन में अगर बहुत स्पेसिफिक सब्सटेंसेस जाते हैं, देर इज अ ब्लड ब्रेन बैरियर. ठीक है, मैं आपको सिंपल लैंग्वेज में बताया बिकॉज यू हैव नॉट येट कवर्ड द न्यूरो नर्वस सिस्टम. ऑल राइट, सो ब्रेन में हर चीज़ नहीं जा सकती, हर न्यूट्रिएंट नहीं जा सकता. इसलिए कहते हैं कि जब ग्लूकोज कम होता है, ब्लड जो ब्रेन जो है वो सिर्फ ग्लूकोज पे चल सकता है. एंड अबाउट द रिसेंट एविडेंसेस, ब्लड कैन ऑल्सो रन ऑन कीटोन्स. ठीक है, so therefore we say that we require nutrients to run our brain. Every kind of substance cannot go to the brain, like proteins which have to go to the muscles cannot go inside the brain. And same is the case with the medicines. Certain medicines can cross that blood-brain barrier, and the other medicines are not allowed to cross that barrier. So the muscles, lungs, and the brain contain the continuous capillaries. And you can see here that these capillaries are continuous, having a tunica intima only. So capillaries have got only the tunica intima, having the endothelial cells, which are simple squamous, and they rest on the basement membrane. Okay, then we have got fenestrated capillaries, have got small pores in them, and they are present in the location like intestines where nutrients have to be absorbed. So we eat lots of food having micro as well as macronutrients like carbohydrates, proteins. They are broken down into smaller particles, and these particles have to be exchanged, and they have to enter from the blood circulation into the intestines, and then they have to go into different parts of the body. So the intestines need fenestrated capillaries along with the endocrine glands and the kidneys. So you can see here that there are fenestra or small openings in these kind of capillaries. Although the cells are tightly packed together. Then we have got another type of capillary, which is a sinusoidal capillary. Sinusoidal capillary are dilated capillaries. They are present in the liver and spleen, and their wall is, you can see here, their wall is large as well as irregular and tortuous in appearance. Okay, intercellular gaps are present in these kind of capillaries. So in the sinusoids, the intercellular gaps are present in between the cells, and the phagocytic cells may be present in the wall of these capillaries so that the harmful or the bacteria or those substances which need to be engulfed can be processed along the walls. So here you can see that the cells are wide apart, having gaps in between. Okay, so we have discussed the type of capillaries, and let's see how many of you are awaking and listening to the lecture. Okay, can you enumerate the types of capillaries now? Okay, the types of capillaries are continuous, fenestrated, and sinusoidal capillaries. And अच्छा, ये बात मैं आप लोगों को समझाना चाहती हूँ कि आप लोगों के जो OSPE exam है, the practical exam, you need to identify the slide in the microscope. And after identification of the slide, you need to give an answer. And you have to prove your answer with the help of three identification points. So for every histological component you study, or you can say that the histology of any organ or any tissue, when you study the histology, you must remember 3 to 5 identification points which should be there, which you should know, that how are you going to identify that slide in the microscope. Otherwise, there is no fun in studying histology. Okay, in the, you have got all the knowledge about every tits and bits, and you don't have the knowledge about the identification points within the within that slide, so there is nothing, you have done nothing. Okay, so you want to go to somewhere and you adopt a wrong bus or you adopt a wrong path, then you are never going to reach at that place. ठीक है, आपने एक टॉपिक में से सब कुछ पढ़ लिया है और आपको अल्टीमेटली यू डोंट नो द क्रक्स ऑफ दैट टॉपिक, देन व्हाट इज द फन ऑफ वेस्टिंग योर होल डे ऑन दैट टॉपिक. ठीक है, सो in a capillary. How do you identify a capillary? You can see here that it has got a smaller irregular lumen as compared to the veins and arteries. ठीक है, यहाँ पे क्योंकि because it is an enlarged picture, therefore you can see a big lumen. Otherwise, as compared to the arteries and veins, it has got a smaller lumen. As well as you can see here that it is lined with simple squamous epithelium. And apart from that, you cannot see that there is any other layer. ठीक है, there is no tunica media, there is no muscular layer, there is no tunica adventitia, just a single layer of simple squamous epithelium and a irregular lumen is present. Okay, but you can see here that there are certain cells which are just attached to the walls and they are known as pericytes. So pericytes are visible on a larger magnification, or you can say that you can view them on the electron microscope. And the pericytes are the contractile cells and they help in the contraction of these capillaries because there is no smooth muscle layer which is present in these capillaries. All right. So what do the pericytes do? They actually regulate the blood flow and they also help in the phagocytosis. And in the brain, they are also responsible for the formation of blood-brain barrier. They also stabilize the endothelial cells and they also help in their maturation. So pericytes are visible in larger magnification and I have just told you their functions. So let's discuss the veins. Okay, before discussing the veins, is there any question regarding the capillaries? Acha, Fawad Tahir says that microscope mein bhi itni clear image hoti. Beta, microscopes available are in good quality and they show you clear images of the slides. Most of the time, the images are quite clear, and if you have got a practice of looking into, you just instantly come up with the answer. All right. Usually, the microscope may the in the exams you need to identify a artery and a vein. Sometimes a large elastic artery is present, sometimes muscular artery is asked in the exam, and you can easily identify them according to the presence of elastic fibers within the muscularis, or you can see tunica media. All right. And in the veins you can identify. I will let you know in the lecture. All right. So capillaries are usually, you can view them as a component within certain organs or something. They are not usually asked as a whole identification in the, as a whole spot in the exam. Okay. Okay, if there is no question regarding capillary, let's move forward to the veins. So you know that the veins are afferent vessels and they carry deoxygenated blood except the pulmonary veins. And they have got a larger lumen as compared to the arteries. And they have got valves in them because the flow of blood is opposite the gravitational force. Therefore, they need valve to allow the flow of blood towards the heart. They have got the tunics, all tunics. This means all layers which are the general histological layers like tunica, intima, media, adventitia, ye sab present hote hain veins mein. But they are less well defined as compared to an artery. They have got thinner walls as compared to artery, and there are less smooth muscle cells and less elastic fibers in the tunica media, but the collagenous fibers are more. So this is how you see a slide. Ek slide ke andar aapko artery ka aap dekhiye ki there is a circular well maintained lumen. Theek hai, follow my pointer. This is the lumen. And this is a circular well maintained lumen in an artery. All right, you can see that there is tunica intima and there is a well developed tunica media, and afterwards you can see that there is tunica adventitia, which is also visible here. All right, but when you see a venule, or you can say a vein, you can instantly recognize, because you can see that the lumen is collapsed, or you can see that the lumen is not circularly arranged, it is in a deformed shape. There is no formed shape of this lumen in a vein. You can see that tunica intima is present, and you can see there is tunica media as well, but you can also see that the layers are not thick. The wall is thin. The wall of a vein is thin as compared to an arteriole, and with the help of that collapsed lumen, you can easily identify. And apart from that, if you have got this query in your mind that how are you going to identify a vein from a capillary, so you can see that it has got quite a larger lumen. ठीक है, एंड इट हैज गॉट अ थिकर वॉल एज कम्पेयर टू द कैपिलरी. ठीक है, कैपिलरी के निस्बत इसकी वॉल थिक है, बट एज कम्पेयर टू द आर्टरी इट हैज गॉट अ थिन वॉल. सो फॉर अ वेन, टू आइडेंटिफाई अ वेन, यू मस्ट रिमेंबर सर्टेन आइडेंटिफिकेशन पॉइंट्स. यू कैन से, और यू कैन राइट इन योर एग्जाम, यू कैन टेल इन योर वाइवा that a vein has got a wider lumen, but it is collapsed. ठीक है, collapsed but wider lumen is present. The wall is thinner as compared to the arteriole. The tunics are present, intima, media, and adventitia, but are less well developed. All right, this is how you can identify veins. And sometimes within the histological slide, sometimes if the slide is made at that point, sometimes the valves are also visible. All right, so especially limbs ki jo veins hain unme valves hote hain, because so that the blood can flow from below upwards or in an anti-gravity position. So there are small size veins which are unnamed, there are medium size veins which we have also discussed in the lecture on mediastinum. You can name them like azygous veins, hemiazygous veins, and large veins we have already discussed in the lecture on heart. Superior vena cava is there, inferior vena cava, and there is also a portal vein. You can also classify them on the basis of the location, like there are superficial veins, deep veins. We have covered the upper limb, and we have discussed that there is a superficial as well as deep venous network, and it ultimately drains into the axillary vein, and certain veins connect the superficial veins with the deep veins, and they are known as communicators or perforators. Theek hai? All right, let's discuss and compare the histology. You can see here that the internal elastic lamina is so well present in the artery, but it is sometimes present, not well developed, and sometimes absent in the case of a vein. And you can see here that the muscular wall of a vein is thinner, the tunica media, as compared to the arteries. But if you see that tunica adventitia, or you can see it as tunica externa, it is of a thicker component, because aap dekh sakte hain ki isme media is thicker but tunica adventitia is thinner as compared to the media. But you can see here that as compared to the media, the adventitia is sometimes thicker or is sometimes equivalent. Okay, so this is how you can identify a vein. And you can also observe in here that valves are present in the veins, whereas they are absent in the arteries. And apart from that, you can see that there is a thicker wall in the artery as compared to that in the vein. And you can see here that the arteries and veins, they become smaller, and ultimately they join to form the capillary network. So this was all about the histology, and if there is any question. Acha, okay, there are certain questions in the comment box, and let me answer those. Anila says that while identifying a slide, do we enumerate the functions of the components as well? No. Functions are physiology. Sometimes certain glimpses are given to you people in the lectures, because obviously you cannot isolate everything. But for identifying the histological slide, you just need to say that it has got simple squamous epithelium, tunica intima is present, tunica media is there, tunica adventitia is there. Okay, beta Ramisha has got a query that I can't identify the tunicas. Beta, this is not a pencil drawn diagram. The original structures are, you can say they are well explained in the books. Every component is not that 100% visible in the case of a microscope. So if you can say that there is a demarcation in everything, like a pencil drawn diagram, that now the tunica intima is finished and now media is starting and then adventitia is there, so there are no harsh lines or boundaries. Okay, first year, thank you very much for your participation, and I appreciate those who are participating in the lecture and who are always participating and giving answer to the questions. And you are most welcome to ask if there are any queries related to the topics which I teach. And okay, we will meet in the Zoom class to discuss the mediastinum, inshallah. And till then, take care of yourselves and your families. Okay, Allah Hafiz.